All right, this is Joaquin Rui from Que Auto Compro. We're here with Mark Savino, product planning manager. Let's take a brief exploration of the 2023 second generation Kia Niro. Every time I look at it, especially in white like this one and the electric that's a little different, I feel I'm looking at a Star Wars stormtrooper helmet. I get similar vibes from the new Sportage. Is that deliberately or am I imagining things?
Well, maybe we didn't go as far as stormtrooper, but we definitely had a really cool concept. 2019 Habanero.
That's right.
Maybe you saw that one. And we applied a lot of the styling elements from that concept onto the production car, including these really cool LEDs. We call these the heartbeat LEDs, standard on the vehicle.
And I think we saw the heartbeat on the K5 as well, if
K5,
I remember correctly.
It's definitely across a lot of our lineup. That's right.
Now, if we go to the side, it's interesting that you're going with this contrasting color at the bottom.
Yep.
And in the back, the seat pillar almost looks like a play on the old Audi side blades on the first Audi R8s. And I'm thinking all the designers that came from Volkswagen to Hyundai Kia. Is that deliberately? Is that influence?
I love it. Well, first of all, I love the Audi R8 reference. And I love Kia and Audi in the same conversation is always a good thing, I think. You know, some of our Audi colleagues have been with us, and we actually have some new colleagues as well. Our head of design, Karim Habib, this car was designed under his tutelage as well.
And now that you're pointing that, I believe there is some like air flow through thing between the, you know, front and back of the seat pillar.
That's right. That's right. So this is actually completely deliberate. It's a complete functional air intake. So there's, you can see some lines here that direct air into a channel behind the seat pillar. If you can get that. And then the air flows all the way to the back portion. You can see the exit vent right next to that boomerang shaped tail lamp. So that aids the airflow. It helps with fuel economy, aerodynamics, stability, turbulence, all of that.
For those that aren't fans of this two-tone look, are there any monochromatic options?
Not fans. How can you not be a fan? I'm just kidding. it's not for everyone. It's not for everyone. It's definitely a bold design. However, you're right. There are options to have this complete body color, so it would be one color.
I'll definitely agree with the bold, because like the first Kia Niro was handsome enough, but you could also say bland and inoffensive, and this is anything but.
That's right. That's right. This is the all new look for Niro, right?
It's gotten
a little bit more bold, and I love these. I love the way the tail lamps integrate into this. It's all, they're all LED tail lamps.
And boomerang is right. That's what that amounts to.
That's right. That's exactly
okay,
right.
Okay, now let's take a quick look at the trunk.
Sure. Smart power lift gate on this car. First time ever on Niro for us. And then check out over 23 cubic feet of cargo space.
Right, and it's a little hard here, but.
Oh yeah, that's where all the good stuff is.
Uh-huh. It's, you know, par for the course, no spare tire, but at least there's a tire inflation kit and a compressor.
And spare tire is an accessory for those who would like to have it.
Well, I guess there is room for it.
There's room.
And one thing that I'm not a huge fan of is where is the plug for 110 volt outlets for those of us that haven't taken the plunge for an at-home charger. I noticed the same thing in the EV, and I'm complaining about it again. Defend yourself.
Well, I mean, it's great that you're doing the 110 volt charging. A lot of our customers are doing the level two. So that really drastically changes the
You're
charging
being too
time.
Polite. You're probably saying, you're an old guy, you're an old fogey. What are you doing with 110? You need at least a level two.
Level two for this guy. Or DC fast charging capable as
Even
well.
Even better.
So that DC fast charging, 43 minutes from 10 to 80% battery charge, state of charge. Yeah.
Now, as we close the hatch, there's one curious little detail.
Sure.
I've noticed the hybrid has HEV little badge, plug-in hybrid has PHEV, why is there no badge? You know, it should probably say EV, I'm electric. Why not?
Well, partially EV does have its own look, right?
True.
So one of the things of its own look is this gray cladding that's unique to some of the, some versions of the EV. It has its unique wheel and it has that bumper in front that's all EV, including the nicely integrated charging port that is integrated into the tiger nose grille. All of these styling features are unique to the EV. But we also learned from our customers is you don't necessarily need to shout that you have an EV. That's what they want, a car that is just a great EV.
And speaking of the front, let's pop the hood and do a couple of things here. First of all, okay, we got this open. So this.
And both parts open.
Okay, so you have to pull this up in order to.
Yes.
And see what am I doing?
There we go. You got it. Check that out. So this is the V to L, vehicle to load. So it takes all the energy that's in the vehicle's battery, the 64.8 kilowatt hour battery, and you can use that to charge whatever you like.
And I'm guessing the poor people that just went through Hurricane Ian in Florida might find this actually useful if they had the foresight to fully charge up their Kia Niro EV.
It can power a refrigerator up to 3 days. It can power your whole house, just do the standard electronics for up to a week. So it has a lot of power in there.
Let's
help you out here.
Okay, and even though this is not built on a dedicated battery electric platform, Kia engineers were clever enough and space efficient enough to provide this little Frunk.
That's right.
Which at 20 liters capacity, I believe.
20 liters capacity.
Is comparable to what you find in an EV6.
That's right. With a little storage net, an LED light, and some anti-slip materials in there. So
cool.
Makes it a little bit easier to store some nice things in the front.
Okay. Now let's take a quick tour of the inside. There's a fair amount of EV6 flavor to it. We have the single large screen. And this looks suspiciously similar, if not identical, the switchable screen to what you find in the EV6. You tell me, are they interchangeable or no?
They're very, very similar, yep. There's a one design that started actually on the Kia Sportage. The first to adopt it, then the EV6, and now the all-new 2023 Niro. And you can see the trick. Right now we're in the HVAC mode. So we have this knob that controls the temperature, for example. And then if we want to, we can change by pressing that button into the navigation radio mode. And then that temperature button turned into a volume knob.
Honestly, when I first encountered that on the EV6, I was not a fan, but I have to admit it's grown on me. It, you know, it says something, it does something to, you know, keep it clean and not filled with 10 gazillion
That's
knobs.
The idea.
And
that's the idea. So it was obviously to be clean, to be very tech forward, very, you know, minimalist amount of space to control a lot. But I can understand because you have to do an extra step. You might notice that the display keeps on switching, and that's because you could set it. If you press and hold, then you could choose if you want a default display, infotainment, or climate, or none at all. So I have it set right now to climate, and that's why it has switched back automatically to climate. But you could, if you preferences infotainment, you could choose that instead, and now infotainment is the default.
Is this rotary knob, you know, for the gear changes exclusively for the electric, or do the HEV and PHEV versions have it as well?
So the PHEV and the EV versions will have the rotary, and the hybrid will have the traditional shift by cable.
I see.
And okay. this area will be the same throughout. You'll have your heated seats, ventilated seats, heated steering wheel, auto hold and park distance camera, and electronic parking brake in the spot. Here, this is your backup camera. You can see the backup camera display with the dynamic guidelines. And that's, as you were mentioning, in that display that reminds you of EV6.
Right.
So that's one of the things we love about this, is this panoramic view between the 10.25 meter, 10.25 center display here. So it gives you the image that you have one big panoramic screen right in front of you. Yeah, we have also here, one thing I'd like to show is we have the drive mode switch right on the steering wheel. When you press that, you can see a different theme between, that's the normal, and then here we're in sport mode. You can toggle right back to eco mode. So that's another cool advantage of the TFT display.
And do they all have drive mode switches or only certain ones?
So the drive mode in the EV, as you can see, we have the normal, sport, and eco. In the case of the hybrids and the plug-ins, we have sport and eco.
Okay. Kia Niro was like the counterpart, if you will, more crossover-ish to the Hyundai Ioniq, which also came in the three alternatives of hybrid, plug-in hybrid, and pure EV. But now that Ioniq has morphed into almost a sub-brand of EVs only, this is the only vehicle in the Hyundai Kia group that offers those three choices of powertrain.
Actually, it's now the only vehicle on the market.
In America.
Yep, that's right.
Oh,
that's
interesting. And do you anticipate more or less the breakdown between the three optional powertrains, what you expect them to be?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the mix between the three, we expect the highest on the hybrid. About half the mix or so would be hybrid. Maybe a little bit more than half the hybrid. About 25 to 30% would be the EV. And the remainder, the smallest percentage, would be on the plug-in hybrid.
Interesting, because I would have thought that's actually the most practical version as far as the, you know, the range anxiety you've got a gas engine to fall back on, yet you're anticipating it'll be the least popular. That's interesting.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, the plug-ins are great cars. I actually think it's my favorite. It's, you know, secretly my favorite version. Because you have more power than you had before. And as you said, you know, you have your all electric range for your in-town errands, shopping. And then if you want to do the road trip, you don't have to worry. So I think the plug-in is a really, really good choice. But typically, you know, like in our market, the pure EV or the pure hybrid, you know, tends to be the popular choices from Americans.
Thank you for sharing this with us, Mark, and for walking us through the new Kia Niro.
It's my pleasure. I'm really, really excited about it. Thanks so much for this opportunity.
Thank you.